Cambridge Bay, Nunavut. This remote and isolated settlement is tucked high into the Arctic Circle, just 1,100 miles from the North Pole.
In the wintertime, 6 weeks go by without any sunlight at all. And only for 3 months of the year is the bay ice-free.
In 2016, below the bay's icy surface, a salvage team inspects a mysterious wooden vessel.
This thing is heavy, and not just because it's massive. Its hull is encased in mud. But to the trained eye, this is a special boat. Its construction is pretty unique.
Whose ship is this? And how did it end up on the bottom of a frozen bay high in the Arctic? The ship is massive. 118 feet from bow to stern, 40 feet across the beam. And the hull is wrapped with a layer of oak, more than 2 inches thick.
Oak is highly valued in shipbuilding because it's strong and durable, but it's also flexible and it resists moisture. But this ship had 2 extra inches of oak on the hull. So that suggests that it was built for a very specific purpose.
The protective layer of oak is similar to the kind of hull built for war vessels. Could this ship have been sunk in a forgotten battle?
On a wrecked warship, you'd be looking for cannons, guns, or other types of military equipment. But they don't see anything like that.
Divers searching the site didn't find any evidence that it was a warship. So then the question is, what else could it be?
The traditional Inuinuktun name for the area is Ikoluktutiak, which means good fishing place. Perhaps this wreck is the remains of a whaling ship.
And that makes sense. Before oil and gas, whale blubber was used for lamp fuel, for soap, among so many other things.
Whalers could have tried expanding their hunting grounds to meet the enormous demand for whale products. There's just one problem with this theory. If this were a whaling vessel, you'd expect to find equipment like harpoons, nets, and guns. And none of that is present here.
The layout of the ship is also unusual. A whaling vessel would definitely be equipped with a compartment large enough to store the meat after it was butchered. This doesn't have anything like that. So what was this ship? And what was it doing here? Determined to solve the mystery, the salvage team raises the ship to the surface. The ship's name has long since faded from its stern.
But a single word on one of the deck boards calls out from the past. Amundsen.
Who is Amundsen? In 1917, in Oslo, Norway, preparations are underway for the very first nautical expedition to the North Pole, unthinkable at the time.
In the late 19th century, as people attempted this expedition and failed, it gave the quest even greater and greater cachet.
There was a very good reason past quests had failed.
It was solid ice all year round. You couldn't just sail to the North Pole.
But the Norwegian explorer leading this new expedition believes it is possible. His name is Roald Amundsen.
He was the Neil Armstrong of the early 20th century. His life was the stuff of dreams. He did things no one could imagine.
In 1905, Amundsen accomplished a feat of navigation that had tantalized Europe for centuries. He sailed from the Atlantic to the Pacific through the Northwest Passage. 6 years later, in 1911, he outdid himself by successfully reaching the South Pole.
His crew followed him because the man was adventurous and a visionary.
Now Amundsen wants to see if there's land beneath the ice at the top of the world. If so, he intends on claiming it in the name of his patron, Queen Maud of Norway, which he believed would establish his place in history forever. His goal isn't to avoid the ice, Instead, he'll sail directly into it.
He was following the latest, greatest science in that the Arctic ice is not some monolith. It actually flows. His idea was to sail to the Arctic, let his ship get caught by the ice so that it would drift to the North Pole. It's not unlike a manned mission to Mars. You load up your ship with provisions and you sit there until you arrive at your destination, hopefully.
But ice is not benign. It crushes everything in its path.
For a project this big, Amundsen needed a ship of the most sophisticated design. He needed a ship that could withstand the rigors of the Arctic ice pack.
Amundsen commissioned a vessel with a very specific shape, and he oversaw every aspect of its construction, even down to the choice of wood used. Norway has huge forests, but Amundsen imported what he considered to be higher quality wood from Holland.
The three-masted schooner had a solid oak frame for maximum structural strength, and it was egg-shaped below the waterline, so when pressed by ice from either side, it would lift the ship up. It had a four-cylinder, 240-horsepower engine that drove a single-bladed screw. The screw and the rudder were both retractable.
The ship was named Maud after the Norwegian queen, and the ship was christened with a block of ice rather than a bottle of champagne.
Could this wreck that's been dredged from the bottom of Cambridge Bay be Amundsen's once magnificent Maud?
At the time it was built, it was one of the most sophisticated machines in the world. And for it to have been forgotten about and really disappeared, it would be the equivalent of mucking around in your backyard and finding, you know, a piece of a Saturn V rocket.
Right away, when you look at the salvage ship, you can see that the dimensions fit. It's about 120 feet long and 40 feet wide. But what really clinches it is the ship's distinct egg shape. He knew that that particular feature would fortify his ship against the crushing power of the Arctic ice pack.
How did one of the most remarkable sailing ships in the world, owned by the most famous polar explorer in the world, end up at the bottom of a bay in Nunavut? Especially when it was launched 4,000 miles away in Oslo, Norway.
The Maud set sail from Oslo in June of 1918. Amundsen's plan was to sail over the top of Russia, across to Alaska, and then enter the pack ice north of the Bering Strait.
But the pack ice was building up earlier than Amundsen had anticipated, so the ship's progress was halted while it was still north of Russia.
It took Amundsen 2 years to make it to Alaska. You could get to Jupiter in less time.
For Amundsen, this North Pole expedition was a bust. And by the time the ship got back to port in 1925, it wasn't even his ship anymore.
Amundsen was broke. His creditors seized his assets, including his beloved Maud, and she was sold to the Hudson's Bay Company.
The Hudson's Bay Company had a radically different plan for the Maud. She became a workhorse, shuttling between Hudson's Bay outposts in the far north.
This was really a bit ridiculous. It would be like using the Mars rover as a delivery van.